Today, I'm going to show you how you can make your text stand out in your next project with 5 simple but very cool text effects, including video and text, neon glow effect, typewriter text and sound, underwater effect, and the always popular text reveal effect. Before we jump into Final Cut Pro, I want to tell you about the sponsor of this video, Envato Elements. It doesn't matter if you edit videos for a living or it's just a hobby. The subscription to Envato Elements could take your videos from just being good to being amazing. It's an all-in-one subscription service that gives you access to over 59 million digital assets. You get unlimited downloads of stock video, royalty-free music and sound effects, video templates, graphic templates, web templates, still images, and much more. And new items are added every single week. Everything Envato Elements has to offer is included for one low monthly fee. You can even try it free for 7 days, and if you don't love it, simply cancel it anytime during your free trial and you won't be charged a penny. This is super helpful if you're trying to grow your business or your YouTube channel and don't have an unlimited budget. Click the link in the video description and see how Envato Elements can help you make better videos. The first effect we'll take a look at today is video and text effect. Select the video clip you want to place inside your text and add it to your timeline. With your playhead at the start of this clip, press Ctrl T to add the default title above your clip. Ripple trim this title clip to the same length as your video. With your title clip selected, double click on the text in the viewer window to select it and replace the default text with your own. In the inspector window, change the font to something heavy and use the size slider to make it nice and big. If you run out of room on the size slider, just click on the number beside it and drag up to make it even bigger. Deselect the title clip in your timeline, hover over the text in your viewer window until you see a text box, and click and drag the title to center it in your viewer window. Select the video inspector, and from the blend mode drop-down menu, select Stencil Alpha. This places the video clip under your title inside the letters with a black background. For my example, to make it more visible, I'll add a custom generator clip above my text and change the color to white. To place this generator clip under your text in the video inspector, change the blend mode to behind for this video and text effect. Next, let's take a look at how to make a neon glow title. Once again, add a video clip you want to use to your timeline, move your playhead to the start of this clip, and add a default title above it with Ctrl T. Replace the default text and select your font. Outline fonts work best for this effect, and the one I'm using today is the Nightlight font downloaded from Envato Elements. In the text inspector, change the face color to something bright. Press Command 5 to open the effects browser, and from the text effects category, add the neon text effect to your title clip. If necessary, you can adjust the appearance of this effect in the video inspector. I'm pretty happy with how mine looks, so I'll just leave mine. Place this title in your frame, and to make it fit in a little better, adjust the size and rotation of your text in the text inspector. If we play this clip back, you can see the camera moves, but the text stays in the same place. To make our text move with the camera, we need to track our bottom clip and apply the tracking data to our text. With your playhead at the start, select the bottom clip, and at the bottom of the video inspector, click the plus button to add a tracker. Place a tracking square over the part of your frame that's in focus and has good contrast. Change the tracking method to point cloud. And click the Analyze button to track your clip. Select the title clip in your timeline. Select the Transform tool. And from the drop-down menu beside Tracker, select the Object Track from your bottom clip. This applies the tracking data from your video clip to your title clip, so the text moves with the camera. The third effect we'll take a look at today is the typewriter effect, and for this one, we'll use one of Final Cut Pro's built-in title presets. Go to your Titles and Generators browser, and in the top right, search for the typewriter effect. Add this title above your timeline. Replace the default text, make it bigger, and if you want to, change the font. Go to the Titles inspector, and use the duration slider to adjust the typing speed. Now, to sell this effect even better, I'm going to add a typewriter sound effect, which I also got from Envato Elements. All we need to do now is retime our title clip so the letters match up with the sound. You can't retime the title clip itself, so to get around this, select it and make it into a compound clip with a keyboard shortcut Option G. Go through this compound clip and add a marker whenever each letter pops on screen. Line up the first spike in your waveform with the first marker, and use hold frames to stretch out the title clip to line up the rest. Here's the result. Effect number 4 is underwater text, and this one is also very simple. Place your playhead where you want this text to come in, and press Ctrl+T to add the default title. Replace the text, and adjust the title appearance. Go back to the effects browser, and search for the underwater effect. Add this to your title clip, and use the controls in the video inspector to adjust the appearance of this effect. And as always, I save the best for last. The text reveal effect is by far my favorite. To do this effect, you'll need a video clip with a person or an object that moves across a frame. Add a title above this clip, replace the text, and adjust its appearance. Move your playhead to where the backside of your subject is about to cross the text, and add a marker. Grab your video clip, hold down the Option key, and drag up to make a copy of it. Place it above your title clip. In the effects browser, from the masks category, add a draw mask to your top clip. With your playhead on the marker, add control points on the backside of your subject and a couple on the opposite side to close the mask. In the inspector window, add keyframes to the control points and transform parameters. Move ahead one or two frames and adjust the control points to follow your subject. Depending on the motion in your clip, you might be able to get away with skipping a few frames, or if your clip is like mine, you have to adjust your control points on every frame. Keep going until your full title is revealed. Render out your clip for this cool text reveal effect. So, what do you think? Which one of these was your favorite? Let me know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.